Josh Uncle. Oh.
Duter.
Boy. They only had 2 years in the league before they got released now. Yeah, my nigga's dirt. That should be enough for a practice squad. Welcome back, stream, to a live commentary of Madden 20. First game will be against the Packers, you know. Stay tuned for a blowout. Who's getting blown out? Oh, that's a good question. Oh, yeah, okay. We got Trevon Doe. Yeah, that nigga trash. Our line is weak. Like, weak. He can stay. We don't need him. You can stay. Fourth. No. Fuck is Reese Fountain? How many plays I got? Five.
Yo, get to the goddamn gameplay, dude. Gadia Yaley.
I'm trying to get my team set up so we can get to the next season, bro. Golly. God. Dog. What a practice squad. They want me to cut my first stream. Let go. My line weak as a motherfucker, boy. We don't really need this dude right now. Yeah, you gotta stay. Keep that nigger just in case. This man can go. Hold on, stream. Shit. Fuck, bitch. Who's my receivers? Bet.
Woo wow, bro, really stream reported.
Stream reported for what? It's not like I'm streaming porn. There. We're gonna turn on the ants. We're gonna hop into it. Stream, hold on, stream. I thought we was gonna get into a stream, but I gotta set up my stream. Hold up, stream. Cause they like to fuck up my depth chart. Then we can hop into it, alright? Yeah. We got four running backs, that means.
You said nigger.
Who said that? What are you talking about? Devin said that? Look at the line. The line is weak. Y'all want to see my line? What we got to work with this year? Chris gonna be running for his life. 81. That's the best dude.
Serna. 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 Serna.
Yeah. Oh. Sorry, Chris. For you're about to go through this season.
Ooh, ow, 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 now you gon' act like you ain't say it? Bet.
She said, wow, 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 wow. Okay. I want this man to be my punter. Dig what I'm saying? He's not gonna be my kick returner.
Get me a line, bro. GAH Lee, all trash cans.
Yeah, because all my other linemen were old, so they had to get up out of there. So we got to rebuild the offensive line. Try and do this shit as realistic possible. So we just got to go with what we got. Put your time out. We got 32 running backs on the depth chart. What are you talking about? Slot receiver. Yeah, that'd be cool. Me and Nate in a slot. Yeah, that'll actually work. I put Hamler on the practice squad, didn't I? God, oh. Miles Garrett. Durr Brown at an awful. Cole, Greedy, and then Trevondo. Practice squad looking nice though. We have a good little squad behind us. Alright, let's go. We'll give you 2 years, 4.9. Who was that first dude? Clyde? We're not going to re-sign him. We already got running backs. And he's slow. You had to have at least 3.9 speed to play my offense. Upgrade he knows. Ooh, Chris could upgrade. Chris, what you want upgraded? If you're still in here, type it. Let me know what you want. Here's the rundown. Scrambler, evades pressure in the pocket, makes throws on the run, bringing extra dimensions and shit. Strong arm, make big plays down the field with that bomb. Your throwing power is already 99, so you don't really need that shit. Field general, manage the offenses. And then improviser. Here's your ratings. Let me know. Fifth ranked QB in the league. And you already got. You need one more ability at 95. Charismatic personality. One year, 44 touchdowns. This man won MVP his rookie season. What the fuck? You You said upgrade your improviser? Oh, I ain't bad. That shit was Ja Week. This dude Ja Week, he should get cut, huh? Mari stream. Play the Packers game one. Three straight home games though. What the fuck? They love the Browns. If you're wondering what playbooks I use, it is Ghost and Roach. Took 82 years to find that shit. Look our head coach Marvin, boy. Level 9. A slot receiver. See, that's why I got him in the slot. See what I'm saying? Said Vang, 80 soul. Durbron.
Hello, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on. With you again with scores around the league at halftime.
I don't know what that means.
Right around the corner and standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
All right, coach, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Green Bay Packers and the Cleveland Browns. With my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and Charles, we have arrived.
Welcome to the 2021 season, y'all. Man. We've been waiting for probably like 22 years for this, bro.
Radio shows, no more podcasts, no more just
probably like 32 years we've been waiting on this.
Now we get to see it on the field.
Who this? Oh, I don't want to. Let's go.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end.
All right, hold on. It's making me do some stupid shit right now. Hold on. We have to come back into this. I do apologize, stream. We're having some technical difficulty. It's saying I gotta go delete some shit. You know what I'm saying? I do apologize. Thank you. Gorsh. This one can go. I don't play that one no more. We'll leave that one. That's the newest one. That's the one I'm in right now. What if I deleted that shit?
You know how mad I'll be. To me too, you'd have set that shit up, boy.
Why do I even have Face of the Franchise? Turn that bullshit off. Stream, I do apologize for the lag in gameplay. Just gotta figure out what to delete. This one can go. I definitely don't play that one no more. So I'm in the 27 right now. 31. I know what team that is, I just forgot. This 19 can go. February 13th can definitely go. And then February 7th. They make you delete shit, because you don't have enough space, and it just keep popping up throughout the whole damn game. What was you talking about? Like I said, stream, I do apologize for the lag in gameplay. Subscribe if you're new. Send nudes. All that. We're the new look Browns. We're the oranges. Call us the oranges. Don't call us the Browns.
Between the Green Bay Packers and the Cleveland Browns. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, much appreciated, Coach, as we welcome all of you to our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that
Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game.
Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Green Bay Packers and the Cleveland Browns. With my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and Charles, we have arrived at another new season. I had a little more pep in my step this morning. I know you did as well. Here we go.
Yeah, when you went out for your five-mile jog, you were flying. You did it in record time because you were psyched up about this game. But let's be frank about it. No more radio shows, no more podcasts, no more just predicting what's going to happen. Now we get to see it on the field.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Oh,
y'all
start running.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by the former Cal Bear, Aaron Rodgers.
I remember meeting him when he was playing at Cal, and I remember walking away thinking, instead of having Rodgers stitched on the back of his jersey, it should just say confidence, because that's how he felt about his own abilities and his ability to elevate a team.
Look at
Blue 58. Blue 99.
Now the man from UTEP is Aaron Jones.
Dual shot battery level one.
A couple for him there on the game's first play and it's second down. And now the offensive starters for the Packers.
Obviously a tough test for this offense right out of the gate. Road game in game one of the new year. Conventional wisdom says, go slow, take care of the football.
Alright, y'all. Yeah. The stream is gonna happen for us, so we do know we had to rip it out on the field. Come on, man. Come on, man. Still on that.
And the big meat on the D line. We'll see how they do today.
And I'd hate to be an offensive lineman having to deal with these guys. They come in hungry,
come on,
mean, and confident. They think that no one can block them.
Yes, sir. Offense is a little lagging behind their production. Here, though. Here, though. Here, you. Get off. We on that. I got it. I keep forgetting I can skip players in this. I don't even skip players. I'm going to play this whole season.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
It's taken on the 25. He's got this almost to the
lead. No, sir.
Nice job bringing
it. I got what they offense right now.
On the return. And the Browns will take over first and 10.
As if the card for this week don't say week one.
Oh man, I got a fucking car on top of
the roof, bro. Check 43. Switch it.
It's Carter. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49.
Oh man, come on top of the roof, bro.
Let's go, Tim.
Throw
oh no.
Down.
I don't know why I threw this one. I'm supposed to go to Allen in the flat.
Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to hold that one in.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down.
My protection on the right side, homie.
Back to throw. Sanders. Oh, and a back throw there. It's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to midfield strike.
We got this.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're
good, though.
Early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Oh, no, boys.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down now.
Ain't no way. I was hitting every button to tackle that man.
Reach out or something. First down at the Browns 41.
That's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now, I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there.
There you go, Nick. Or Aiden, or Nick.
Every name I know, boy.
Losing 3 yards here, and that'll bring up fourth down. That's tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stump that one for a
shanked
loss.
It.
I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible. This is a dangerous.
Well, this is a guy who is already among an elite group of kickers that have hit from 60 plus in an NFL game, but that's a tough ask to try and get him to produce another one here.
You're exactly right. It's elite group for a reason, isn't it? Yeah. No small feat for him to hit it from that distance. This one doesn't go through, but always marvel at those guys because it's the same approach every time, the same smoothness when they swing their leg. Doesn't look like they're putting anything extra even when they're kicking it for 60 plus.
And this defensive line will be looking to control the point of attack.
And that's what they've done throughout this season. This is a terrific unit. They play together
Trevor
very, very well, and they don't permit big plays to happen.
That's a bet, though.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Some fake.
Second and 10. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. On first down, it's Carter.
Same thing, I know we're trucking, but I've been hitting the truck stick. You don't talk no about it. I'm not even sure you have a truck by Christian Kirksey.
The reception good for seven. It's third down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Here's Sanders. Third and two.
You don't know he's going to catch that right tackle.
Right, he takes it down to 13 and picks up the first.
Most
first catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. This quarterback now, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. 49. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage.
See, he had an offensive line.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play.
Ooh, I thought I got to sleep underneath everybody.
And he's able to work it here to the
and telling you, there's some nice plays in this playbook, boy. They don't pick it up, boy. I'm going to be surprised, boy.
Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm
you got a read option to go receive it out there. Where did you find that at? I didn't know
he didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the
receiver
right
there.
As he's tackled at the one.
I'm not sure he would have picked out that play as the one to run in that situation. How about the guts of the offensive coordinator dialing that one up into great success?
Come on now.
Guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
What you talking about?
On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before going to slant. In this amount of time, I think it's a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Field it about a yard deep.
Who that?
We'll tackle 34.
The decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20.
Nope.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And the last go around for them, they tried that really long field goal. Couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position. The ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe there's a double shot of confidence.
Yeah, my play.
The kicker could make it. And even if he missed, confident in their defense that they could hold it.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. No
way. He's going to the front.
The number one pick is Garrett coming in to drop him.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Damn. That just heard me throw my phone. Hold on, brothers. 42 Doug.
The job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones.
Yeah, I want to hit the light. Hit the light receiver. Hit the light
to about the 14. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole. Yeah. Third and long.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, a guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
What happened? Oh.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
I'm 42 low. You want to get high?
Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively.
Let's go, man, on
these
receivers.
Shotgun now for Rodgers.
Where you going? I mean, I gave it up at the end right there. I was trying to go sack him, so he started running. I'm pressing him.
That also leads to fourth down.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall. And they could put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
Give me a return set up. I'm going right.
Fielded at the 33.
Kind of hurt somebody. I just kicked that dude in the face.
And the Browns have a short field in front of them now as they take over first and 10.
When I first heard this song, I thought it was Kid. Kid. I thought it was Kodak Black.
They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks. Double this guy.
You can't run with Sammy like this, boy. Sammy got comfortable. The big fella,
he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey.
Oh, he's in.
These pants make me look fat, and we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man.
He is well over 12,000 pounds. He's a big man.
On second down, it's Carter. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop it.
Six rushes, negative five.
They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down.
Doesn't take any great analysis on my part. It's been pretty obvious. Last couple of plays, these guys have been going in the wrong direction.
Offensive line overwhelmed on those plays. Now, I think it's safe to say going to the air here on third. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Preston Smith comes in for the sack. Man, he got in there so quickly.
Yeah, no, Nick,
what could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking scheme.
Barely made it.
Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back.
Yeah, helmet, you did for the head.
But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent. Every man special. Well,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've got to be on the field a lot more than normal. They've got some tough spots.
Use your head,
when you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right. It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys.
Oh, yeah,
and when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Throwing again on second down. Rodgers, he goes right back to Adams. That's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a...
The odds of plays both the music videos first. All right, two of them.
The Packers are on third down. 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. Here it's 3rd and 2.
Yeah, that works. Slipped to the corner, but that works.
But no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. A 3-yard loss. 4th down now.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in his first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle.
Damn, see, every time I don't want to field it,
and
I want
nice
to, come on.
Here to down this one right on the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5.
I got an X factor. All right, man.
Al Sanders. Play action.
Throw the ball. Give me the whole throwing motion, dude.
Assist on that one, pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt, and if the ball goes in the end zone,
make the whole thing motion,
bro. Great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
Get ready, get ready, get ready.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Coming in here, that's a chance of having a big year
based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
Mike, we're 18.
Check 15, check 15.
Yeah, that just. Get off the block. Come on, Key. He got sucked into that.
Back at the 47. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they thought they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one by the line of scrimmage.
The Packers on third down. Not good. 0-for-4 thus far. This is 3rd and 9.
Rodgers on the
able to connect, incomplete. I give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
He stepped out. I'm about to say. He caught the ball.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again. That is just one of those oddities in scoring.
Come.
Intercepted.
They really tripping with this shit, bro.
And what a return as he brings us all the way back down to the 20-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is this horoscope off? Is biorhythms? What is
this horoscope off? Check show, bitch. Horoscope and biorhythms.
Rodgers. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there.
One-handed catch, but he lost 2 yards.
That's a throw. We see guys like that make that type of a catch. Not fair, it goes through my brain. That size, that speed, and now they're acting like wide receivers,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, tight end one-handed catches. They're kind of like wide receiver one-handed catches nowadays.
Just not right.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend.
Yes, sir.
And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. The completion
to a field goal.
Six, and that'll bring up
it should be beamless.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. You've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
So the 3 points there gets them a bit closer, but you can bet there's probably some guys on that sideline, Charles, thinking we deserve a better play.
No doubt, Brandon. Those 2 misses earlier kind of hanging over him right about now. In a tight one like this, if those are
missed, I know Jules, he can be back there.
This is a completely different game.
There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. Let's get back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing.
Can't run out that play. Can't run at all, to be honest.
Touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
On second down now, it's George.
That's the most you got that formation or any run all day, boy.
Called an 8-yard gain, much better shape now on third and just a yard.
Yeah. Look at my guys, that dude.
Sanders from the gun on third down. He's going to loft it on deep left side here. Incomplete.
Apparently 97 speed is not there.
Couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
Hold my daily, just hold it and see it. Oh, Andy.
It's Hernandez. And they'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A big play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep.
How'd he bring it out?
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will. I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee.
I thought he caught that shit.
Regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will it be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'm going to be a fly on the wall for this one, man.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half.
Ooh, ran into a wall.
Just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on. Here's what we think.
He just ran through them, dude. Like, what type of pass defense is that? Running through somebody.
Be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Now he's going to do it again. All right.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. A pickup of 24. And that's where the play began, the 24-yard line.
Clearly,
to win any round,
the under center spread is not working.
That's exactly what happened here.
Spread
them
out. Spread
them
out.
Spread
them out. See what they're working with.
Complicates
all right,
things.
Looks like the running back standing every play.
18 yards to go now on second down.
Yeah, he's already off. I'm looking at him downfield. I saw him at the corner of my eye. He's already off there right there.
Sets him up for third down.
That dude's getting tore up. Mentally and physically.
And let's see, the Packers defensively 6 DBs, so a dime look on third.
Could play coverage or bring pressure.
Fuck. Why even give me the option then, bro?
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw.
Ooh, throwing past the first.
And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words,
oh, yeah.
Look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah,
I'm booming it out the end zone.
Sight! And now on 4th and 1, it's a fake. Fighting his way
to the end
zone. 17 yards on the
field. Look, I kicked that?
First down.
No, I had to put Devin back there. Not my fullback. I was my fullback here, but I'm back here. Guaranteed.
He's got to be a guy that can be pretty agile, too, right?
Yeah, without a doubt, because you're talking about a guy, even in protection, he may have to slide up and down the line of scrimmage to pick up someone who comes through trying to block a punt. So you know he's got that ability to
move. That Uke was slow.
Oftentimes, it's usually a running back, a fullback, someone who's used to having the ball in their hands, and he's able to pick up the first down.
I gotta think about this when I'm calling plays, you know what I'm saying? Because that right side is weak. The dude that was open, by the time he get open, I'm sacked.
Just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Sanders now. Throwing out to the wall. Complete. Now they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's 4th.
Everybody else was coming, bro.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy can hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant to the flag.
Yeah, what's that shit?
There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket.
And that was short.
So put another 3 on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field. But they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number two. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big...
Hold it up.
Shocker. Try and get after him early and try and create a big play to give himself some momentum.
See what they have.
Ooh, gotta be fast.
But this one winds up to be
incomplete.
Intended receiver. But it'll be second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm gonna follow right along with you.
He got me. Don't matter.
Escape and he goes down. Garrett picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Miles Garrett.
The offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
He completes it to Jones. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. Call it a 3-yard gain, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's J.K. Scott now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards, real strong. And out will come the offense as they take over. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like what you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on the lead and play that way, it doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense.
What would you do best?
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead the big way. The best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it second and eight. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. Sanders looking to throw on second down. Oh, he's going to be wide open. Complete. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle is made at the Packers 42.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
They'll run on first down. George.
What happened to 71?
He is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Tackles made at the Packers 28. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue all that time and find someone open downfield. He won't cover for so long. So maybe they want to go for a zone blitz. If they lost the game ultimately, they drop the defensive end down. He ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try to get more pressure at the passer.
There you go.
7 yards there at a first down.
He's going to hit that corner. Right on top of me. Hold up, Chris.
From the red zone now.
Nope, I'm not. There's all those eight guys around me. An error occurred. Come on now.
old age learn how to get paid. They don't listen to the haters trying to view your ass out. Bruh, it's not even letting me load the shits. Hello. I had to go to your profile on my friend's list to join the party because the party stream is fucking up again.
Oh no.
It must be something with the party system, though. Because
probably.
We're not used to having this many people now. So I don't know. Can't nobody go out no more.
It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Fat. Third and five now. And this should be the final play before the
fact
quarter.
Six.
So he'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Hey, Doug Cardi, why you killed me, dude?
Sanders from the down on third down.
Oh, I'm going to put another pick.
It's incomplete.
Why is this playing twice?
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there?
Oh, that was the mule
was
video.
Absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly.
It's called,
right.
He put stay home.
You gotta try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Oh,
so now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. This to make it a three-score game late. Kick is good.
Are these videos you released with the deluxe?
Yeah.
So with that, you figure that this game's pretty much out of reach at this point. Three scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though? Let's just feel it at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 20-yard line. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar.
They're going to go deep.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm. A lot of times, the punter will just puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. You might need a massage for the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Here's Rodgers.
Sack again. We on everything.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never know what's going on with the quarterback. They just know about the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Now Rodgers. He's got it. The tight end.
Ooh, right there.
They get seven there, but it brings up four. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and lead the game out that way.
He's going to walk on the left side here. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The Packers unable to pick up the first. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down three scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
That's my controller. Stop vibrating.
After they didn't get it, does it really matter? It really doesn't. They had to go and try to make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz,
okay, you got a little spin on him, okay.
So they can't run.
Oh, yeah.
As that sets him up for third down. The offense on third down tonight, they've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. He's got his tight end, David Njoku.
They fumble.
And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity.
Devin, get on, bro.
Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to it.
That's what I'm talking about.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely want to bleed things out of this.
And he takes this one in for Brown's score.
Right up the middle.
A great effort there. Taking it in. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time. Looking at week one, oh good, we're at home. This is why you want to be home in week one. They're looking sharp.
And I agree with you totally. That's what you want. But there carries a little extra pressure with that as well, because you and I both know protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it, yeah, we want it. But now you actually have to go out and prove it.
Yeah, two sides to that coin, and looking like they're going to protect it here in this one.
Let's win. Let's go.
The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And last time this unit was out here.
Dang, controller, why are you still? Thank you. Golly.
That turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
Every time I die, my controller vibrates for an extra, like, 2 minutes after I die.
That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. 17 yards on the play there as the Packers have the first down as well.
My cooking always makes me hear a jet by another.
Not come out. They needed to account for him on each and every play.
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means his entire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else.
Who did I hit?
Is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
He's got Herndon, his tight end. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 36.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Rodgers now on first down.
Come on, dude. Save video clip. Come on.
It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll make this a second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6.
That was crazy.
Rodgers again now.
That's double cover.
And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Rodgers will bring him up to the line, first and 10. And he's hit on all 5 of his pass attempts on this drive so far.
They're not going to fumble. They're going to score. I already know. Here comes the score.
And that'll bring up second down.
Here comes the score.
Here comes the score. And again, this time to the tailback. And he's going to take this down close to a first down at the Browns 14.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
The Packers on third down. It has been a disaster. 0 for 8
thus
far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Rodgers now to throw. And that is incomplete.
That's lockdown coverage screen.
Completion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
And Elliott puts this one through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick.
in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points.
Oh, they almost got that shit back, boy.
I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
Down. It's Carter. Get into the 40. Broke a tackle there to get some extra yardage. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. They'll keep it on the ground. Carter.
There we go.
Not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31 yard line. 9 yards.
What?
Pick up there, and it's a first down.
Now I'm getting yards.
I have to juggle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I can be in that hole with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. You got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They'll run on first down. It's Carter. Gets a pickup before, and it'll bring up second down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Read up. See how I almost got the animation and then it just sucked me back in? This shit dumb as motherfucker, man.
With a third and about four for a first.
Well, they
that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred.
How did he get stuck on your dude? Butch.
And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short.
Stuck on dude, butt cheek, huh?
Yes. Some bullshit.
The Packers D comes up with a big stop. So we were looking at each other up here in the booth when they went for that sale. Oh, wow. Talk about trying to add insult to injury.
Some teams are just like that.
They ran the ball up there. They got some coaches are like, look,
I got a chance to put some more points on the board. I don't care what the situation, I'm going to do it. And they're also the same coaches as a general rule. That if someone does it to them, you're going to hear people protest out about it. It's just who they are.
Let me get to the corner. I'll pick that on.
He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. But now it's third down. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion.
That's who he's facing for throw to.
Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. As a final stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. Deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is taken around the 12.
Oh, I thought I had him.
A great return there. Bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 43.
No time to throw the ball.
Throwing to start the drive. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43.
Watch the pass. Mike's going to
do it. It looks like he'll throw it here. He's going to loft it on deep left side here.
Incomplete.
He's still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And partner, I must say, good to see you again. Been too long. And it's good to have football back, isn't it?
Didn't you see me in preseason? Weren't we together in preseason?
Yeah, but preseason, you know, it's preseason. This is week one.
Oh, you're trying to say real football.
Yeah, real football.
Not preseason football, yeah. Where we shake down the rosters and figure out who's going to play. And maybe the starters don't play as much. Now it's the frontline guys. From the first whistle.
Yeah, I tuned you out in the preseason. And now I'm listening to you.
So for the Browns, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Packers, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
It's okay with me if one of my brothers are at the top of the game. When Loso was at top, he's the best one out right now. Like, I'm pretty sure that motivated them. And right now, they're motivating me. Same thing. Like, just because they're winning doesn't necessarily mean I'm losing. And I think a lot of people have that problem.
I'm team. Back.
Fuck.
Yeah, that's combination. A hot dog, it's a pizza.
Mm-hmm. Hot dog and pizza.
It's not that weird.
Hot dog and pizza.
That's like concession stand food.
Yeah. I'm a pistol or max besides the decoy.
I'm surprised.
Yeah, hardcore make it easy for that.
You know, I'm talking about the Deagles and Max.
It make it, I don't know. The Deagle's still kind of slow, so it's harder to use in hardcore.
True.
I was just bussing noggins. I literally just went on a whole 9 kill streak in the corner with this Desert Eagle.
And you said it was slow.
I was wrong, I guess. Sheesh.
whatever you're going to do, just do it. Never thought about doing you.
Oh, I missed.
Who's watching the stream? Mm-hmm. Who is watching?
Teammates.
Show yourself. Show thyself. If I hear about this stupid ass landscape one more time. Yeah, we're chilling.
Big day. I mean, Foxy was in here for Johnny's Pants Coffee, but he's back. The boys and I are pumped to talk to you about everything happening.
Four home games in a row. That means our last games of the season are going to be on the road. I already know.
What kind of news are you breaking on a daily basis?
Oh, really?
Well, we didn't break it.
Just cut the gap in the season. Okay. From week 9 to week 12. That's a whole month. No, from week 8. I think I can trade this dude.
Yeah, you are. I guess so. I guess Jake.
Oh, so teammate.
For right tackle.
Yeah, and then that's the big question. Going forward, they have maintained the fact that Taysom Hill is their quarterback of the future. He's only thrown the ball 7 times to New Orleans Saints players. Jameis Winston already leads him. Jameis Winston has thrown the ball to New Orleans Saints players 10 times in his career. So he has more completions, not only for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and in his NFL career, but he also has more completions to the team that he's joining than the other backup quarterback.
That's messed up.
So I think this is a, hey,
they said Jameis has more completions to the Saints because he has 10 interceptions to the Saints than Taysom Hill does. Because Taysom Hill only has 7 completions.
Sorry. How do you get played a game? I literally killed the whole team twice. On my own.
And no streaks?
Yep. Oh, UAB, but that's it. I wonder if what
I can get this dude if I give him a first, second round, and a left end. They only want their left end interest is only five though, so I don't know if they're gonna give me. No, let's see if I give him two first round picks. I need an offensive lineman. I'm not gonna get tossed around like a fucking clothes in a dryer.
Speaking of that, I need to go get my clothes out of the jar.
So do.
And move my clothes in the washer over to the dryer.
Alright.
I ain't gonna do that right now, though. Damn, I'm just gonna do it in the morning.
Might as well. They don't want Miles Garrett, but they'd rather have the other dude.
You can't trade Coach Dizzle. I'm not in my trip. I was thinking Jason Garrett. Miles Garrett trash. I wouldn't want him either.
Jason Garrett.
Relax,
God bless. Alright, who has a good right tackle they're trying to give up? Apparently nobody. Shit. Nah, we'll keep the defense.
Dude, why are you just sitting? Okay, dude. This nigga here, dog.
My window open. What the fuck? Yeah, he did. Who's the top dude? Saints. Saints are already nasty.
Don't even know what to check me.
These interior linemen suck.
Select the team you want to join.
Probably wasn't for much more money than he signed for. Or was it also
start your season with
I hate when niggas be wearing extra medium t-shirts. It's like, dude, you're a bigger shirt, dude.
What are you, you know you way bigger than that. Come on now.
I'm saying you look stupid. And it'd be celebrities too, like, bro. The rappers are wearing like fucking extra small t-shirts, knowing they need a large.
I saw Ha Ha Davis wearing one the other day on one of his videos.
It's like, dude.
No, that's not the right size.
It's zipped all the way up.
That's
like this right here. Yeah, that's a good. That is a good. Need a tight end. Give him a tight end.
Oh, you're going. No, I'm t-shirt with the three quarters. I never wear the other. Okay.
That's fair.
Bro.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, are you serious?
That's out of stretch.
This okay, dude. Just, okay. This man is doing nothing but okay. I'm leaving this game. I'm not standing here. That is allegedly worth billions.
I swear they do that every fucking time. All right, let's do some investigative work real quick then.